Hi students, hello everyone, all the best. Today I am going to teach about human health and disease. It is comes under unit 3 and chapter 8. So under this topic we are going to study what is health according to World Health Organization and good humor hypothesis, and what is disease and what are the different types of disease. So we are going to study all these things under this topic. First point, what is a health? According to World Health Organization, health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being, not merely the absence of disease. ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಮಾನಸಿಕವಾಗಿ, ದೈಹಿಕವಾಗಿ, ಸಾಮಾಜಿಕವಾಗಿ ಸದೃಢನಾಗಿರಬೇಕು ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾಯಿಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಹೊರತುಪಡಿಸಿ. ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಅಂಥ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ನಾವು ಆರೋಗ್ಯವಂತ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್, ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್, ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ವೆಲ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್, ನಾಟ್ ಮಿಯರ್ಲಿ ದ ಆಬ್ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ತ್ ಆರ್ಗನೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು good humor hypothesis. According to good humor hypothesis, health is a state of body and mind. Health is a state of body and mind. There was a balance of certain humor. Humor means body fluid. Humor means body fluid such as blood, black bile, yellow bile and phlegm, pitta, vata, kapha. It is asserted by Hippocrates and Indian Ayurvedic system of medicine. According to good humor hypothesis, health is a state of body and mind where there was a balance of certain humor. Humor means body fluid. That includes blood, black bile, yellow bile and phlegm. It is assorted by Hippocrates and Indian system of medicine. So according to good humor hypothesis, black bile, so humor secreted by gallbladder and spleen, belongs to hot personality and would have fever. So this is the definition for health according to World Health Organization and good humor hypothesis. Next point is, what are the factors affecting health? So what are the factors affecting health? There are various factors affecting health. That is number one. Environmental factor. Environmental factor like light, temperature, soil and job, house, family atmosphere, person lifestyle. That includes food and water we take, rest and exercise that we give to our body, and habits that we have or lack. Genetic disease, deficiency disease, infectious disease, etc. These are the factors affecting health. So good health can be maintained. Good health can be maintained by taking balanced diet, regular exercise, yoga, awareness about disease and their effects, vaccination against infectious disease
and proper disposal of waste. These are the factors affecting health. So what is health and what are the factors affecting health? Next point, what is a disease? Next point is, what is a disease? The meaning of disease. Dis means against. Easy means comfort. That is against to the comfort. So what's the definition for disease? Any condition which interferes with the normal functioning of the body and impairs the health, that is called as disease. Any condition which interferes with the normal functioning of the body and impairs the health, that is called as disease. The disease causing organisms. The disease causing organisms are called as pathogens. In bacteria, there are two different types of bacteria: beneficial bacteria and harmful bacteria. Beneficial bacteria are used to prepare curd, dosa, idli, cheese, and then sewage treatment and for the production of biogas. But harmful bacteria that causes disease. Hence they are called as pathogen. Generally speaking, the disease causing organisms such as bacteria, virus, helminth, protozoans are called as pathogens. So there are two different types of disease. There are two different types of disease. Number one, congenital disease, and number two, acquired disease. There are two different types of disease. That is, number one, congenital disease, and number two, acquired disease. So congenital disease are inborn disease which are occur by birth. Congenital disease are inborn disease occur by birth, and it is inheritable. That means it transmits from one generation to another generation. Example, disease caused by gene mutation like hemophilia, color blindness, sickle cell anemia, thalassemia, and chromosomal disorders like Down syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome, Turner syndrome, Patau syndrome, Edwards syndrome. These are all called as chromosomal disorder. They are all congenital disease. These are all inborn disease and which are occur by birth and it is inheritable. Next one is acquired disease. So what is acquired disease? This disease occur after the birth and non-inheritable. On the basis of the communication, acquired disease are of two types. That is, communicable disease or infectious disease, and number two, non-communicable disease or non-infectious disease. Acquired disease can be further classified into two types, that is communicable disease or infectious disease. Number two, non-communicable disease or non-infectious disease. So what is communicable disease? What is communicable disease or infectious disease? These diseases are transmitted from infected person to healthy person through the contaminated air, water, food, and vector and physical contact. Since these diseases are caused due to infection of microorganism, hence it is also called as infectious disease.
non-communicable disease or non-infectious disease. These diseases, non-infectious disease or non-communicable disease, do not spread from unhealthy person to healthy person. So that is called as non-communicable disease or non-infectious disease. So communicable disease. Communicable disease can be further classified in communicable disease transmit from infected person to healthy person through the contaminated air, water, food and physical contact and vector. So it can be further classified into contagious communicable disease and non-contagious communicable disease. What is contagious communicable disease? These communicable diseases can spread from infected person to healthy person by actual contact or physical contact. They are, example, STD, sexually transmitted disease, smallpox, chickenpox, leprosy, measles. These are all contagious communicable diseases. Non-contagious communicable diseases. These communicable diseases can spread from infected person to healthy person through the contaminated food, air, water, etc. Example, cholera, TB, typhoid, ascariasis, and pneumonia. Next one, non-communicable disease. Non-communicable disease or non-infectious disease. There are four different types. Non-communicable disease or non-infectious disease. There are four different types of non-communicable disease. They are deficiency disease, degenerative disease, cancer, allergy. What is deficiency disease? These diseases occur due to the deficiency of nutrients, hormones, and vitamins. Example, diabetes mellitus, caused due to the deficiency of insulin. Diabetes insipidus, caused due to the deficiency of antidiuretic hormone. Kwashiorkor, caused due to the deficiency of protein. Pituitary dwarfism is caused due to the deficiency of growth hormone. Next one is degenerative disease. These diseases caused due to the denaturing of or degeneration of body tissue. Example, cardiovascular disease, stroke and arthritis. Next one is cancer. It is caused due to uncontrolled mitotic cell division and growth to form tumor. Cancer, it is caused due to uncontrolled mitotic cell division and growth to form tumor. That is called as cancer. And then allergy. What is allergy? It is an exaggerated response of immune system to certain allergen present in the environment. That is called as allergy. The agent or the substance that causes allergy are called as allergen. Example, household dust, animal dander, and pollen grains are called as allergens. Example for allergy is asthma and hay fever. So these are all called as degenerative disease, deficiency disease, cancer and allergy are called as non-communicable disease because they do not spread from unhealthy person to healthy person. Next one, what is etiology? The study of causes of disease is called as etiology.
study of causes of disease is called as etiology. So what is epidemiology? So the study of mode of transmission of disease is called as epidemiology. Preventive measure is called as prophylaxis. Preventive measure of disease is called as prophylaxis. So study of mode of transmission of disease is called as epidemiology. Study of causes of disease is called as etiology. The substance or the agent which causes disease by its excessive secretion or deficiency or absence is called as disease agents. Next, we are going to study. So, common infectious disease of man. So, common infectious disease of man. They are bacterial disease, viral disease, helminth disease, and protozoan disease. Bacterial disease, viral disease, helminth disease, and protozoan disease. So, we are going to study all this. Very first one is bacterial disease. Among bacterial disease, we are going to study about typhoid. Typhoid is also called as enteric fever. Typhoid is also called as enteric fever. Enteron means intestine. Typhoid is also called as enteric fever. So causative organism or causative pathogen of typhoid is Salmonella typhi. Salmonella typhi is a bacteria that causes a disease known as typhoid or enteric fever. Mode of infection, that is epidemiology. Salmonella typhi enters into the small intestine through the contaminated water and food and migrates to other organs of the body through the blood. The incubation period is about 1 to 3 weeks. And next one is the symptoms. So symptoms of typhoid. What are the symptoms of typhoid? Number one, classic typhoid fever, that is high fever, about 39 degree centigrade up to 40 degree centigrade or 104 degree Fahrenheit. Number two, weakness. Number three, stomach pain. Number four, constipation, headache, loss of appetite. What is it? Next one, intestinal perforation or ulcer that causes hemorrhage. Hemorrhage means bleeding. And death may occur in severe case. These are the symptoms of typhoid. Next one is diagnosis. How can you diagnose typhoid? So typhoid can be diagnosed. So typhoid may be diagnosed or may be confirmed by white oil test. Typhoid may be confirmed or diagnosed by white oil test. Note, a case study is made on typhoid. Mary Malone was commonly known as Typhoid Mary. She was a professional cook and typhoid carrier. She continued to spread typhoid for several years to the family members through the contaminated food she prepared. So this is the case study made on typhoid about Mary Malone. She was commonly called as Typhoid Mary. Next bacterial disease is called as pneumonia. So preventive measure of typhoid. So preventive measure is called as prophylaxis. So how can you prevent typhoid? Number one, typhoid can be controlled by providing proper sanitation of feces of the patient. Number two, by supplying screened pure drinking water. Number three, by providing hygienic food. And number four, by taking vaccine like tab vaccine and typhoid oral vaccine. And next, by taking antibiotic. So these are all about typhoid. So causative pathogen of typhoid, symptoms of typhoid, mode of infection, control measure, and the diagnosis of typhoid. Next, bacterial disease is called as pneumonia. So pneumonia, once again, under pneumonia we are going to study causative organism or pathogen of pneumonia, mode of infection, and symptoms. So the causative organism of pneumonia, it is caused by bacteria, virus, and protozoa. Pneumonia is caused by bacteria, virus, and protozoa. Bacteria that causes pneumonia, like Streptococcus pneumoniae, Diplococcus pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenza, Mycoplasma. Virus like adenovirus, protozoa like Entamoeba histolytica. So there are different types of pneumonia according to the pathogen, like bacteria, virus, and protozoa. So these are the causative pathogen of pneumonia. Next one is mode of infection, that is epidemiology. These pathogens present in the sputum, that is phlegm, of the patient and enters into the lung of healthy person by inhaling contaminated droplets through coughing and sneezing. So this is the mode of infection, that is epidemiology. Next one is symptoms. Symptoms of pneumonia. What are the symptoms of pneumonia? Very first point, fever with chill, chali jara, cough and headache. Alveoli get filled with fluid. Alveoli get filled with fluid. So this is alveoli. The structural and functional unit of lung is called as alveoli. Alveoli is get filled with lymph or fluid. So, and it causes severe respiratory problem. First symptoms is fever with chill. Second one is cough and headache. Alveoli get filled with fluid or lymph and causes severe respiratory problem. In severe case, lips and fingernail may turn grey to greyish in color. So these are the symptoms of pneumonia. Preventive measure is isolation of patient. Isolation of patient is the preventive measure of pneumonia. So both typhoid and pneumonia are bacterial disease. Next, we are going to study viral disease. There are so many viral diseases. They are dengue, chikungunya, hepatitis, AIDS, polio, rabies, Japanese encephalitis, coronavirus. These are all viral diseases. So we are going to study about only the common cold. So what is common cold? Common cold.
So common cold. Casualty organism or casualty pathogen of common cold is rhinovirus. Rhinovirus causes common cold. In some other textbook it is given, coronavirus is also causes common cold. So casualty pathogen of common cold is rhinovirus. Next, mode of infection, that is epidemiology. This pathogen spread through droplets like coughing and sneezing of the infected person. It may transmit through contaminated object like pen, book, cup and computer mouse. Pathogen infects only the nose, not the upper respiratory tract, but not the lungs. This pathogen infects only the nose and upper respiratory tract, but not the lung. Coronavirus infects the lung. Rhinovirus infects only nose and upper respiratory tract, but not the lung. Coronavirus infects the lung. Next one is symptoms of common cold. Number one, nasal congestion. Nasal congestion means moogu kattukondaga. Nasal congestion. Watery discharge from the nose. Watery discharge from the nose. Sore throat. Gantalalli kich kich. Hoarse voice and cough. Headache and tiredness. These are the symptoms of common cold. Casualty pathogen, mode of infection and symptoms of common cold. So this is viral disease. Next one is helminth disease. Helminth means, last year we have studied about Ascomyces and Platyhelminthes. Helminth means worm. So under this topic we are going to study helminth disease. That is number one, ascariasis. That is number one, ascariasis. The name of the disease is ascariasis. Same time, casualty organism, mode of infection and symptoms. So casualty organism or casualty pathogen of ascariasis is Ascaris lumbricoid or Ascaris megalocephala. Ascaris lumbricoids or Ascaris megalocephala causes a disease known as ascariasis. So Ascaris is an intestinal parasite. That is, it is present in the intestine of man. Ascaris is an intestinal parasite. It is commonly called as roundworm and it is common in case of children. The life cycle of Ascaris is monogenetic. That is, it involves only one host, that is man. Hence it is called as monogenetic. It shows sexual dimorphism, that is male Ascaris and female Ascaris. Male Ascaris copulates the female Ascaris and female Ascaris lays about 15,000 capsulated eggs per day and excreted along with the feces and infect and person which contaminate the soil, water, plant, etc. Male Ascaris copulates the female Ascaris. Female Ascaris lays about 15,000 eggs, capsulated eggs per day and excreted along with the feces of the infected person, which contaminates the soil, water, plant, etc.
So mode of infection, cyst, the capsulated egg is called cyst. Cysts are rapidly formed larva. The larva of Ascaris is called as rapidly formed larva. Cysts are rapidly formed larva of Ascaris may ingested through the contaminated water, food, fruit, and vegetable. The passive vectors are flies and cockroach. Important. It is been asked in the previous year question paper. So passive vectors are flies and cockroach. Symptoms. So symptoms of ascariasis is number one, abdominal pain, muscular pain, anemia, nausea and vomiting, blockage of intestine, enteritis, that is inflammation of intestine, internal bleeding and fever. These are the symptoms of ascariasis.